Hi guys, how are you? I'm Laura from Couch Polyglot, and in this video I would like to talk about the expression happy birthday in different languages. My birthday is coming up, so I thought it's interesting to compare the different ways to say that, because yeah, every language says it kind of differently, and I think yeah, it's interesting to see that. So for instance, in English we say happy birthday, so we say okay, the day you were born should be kind of happy, right? But for instance, in Catalan, the most typical way to say that is per molts anys, which means for many years. So we don't have any reference to the birth date, even though, of course, that's what's being celebrated, right? So I think it's interesting. Of course, there are different ways to say that, and also depends on the region. But yeah, this is like a very widespread one to say, per molts anys. And yeah, in Spanish, for instance, we use feliz cumpleaños. So happy having more years or making more years. I don't know how you would translate that literally. Of course, it means happy birthday, right? And what's also interesting here is that we can also cut the word. So in informal situations, we would just say feliz cumple. So we just take the word años out. So we see in both Catalan and Spanish, we have the words years in this happy birthday, which we don't have in English. So I think it's interesting. For instance, in French, it's, I think, the most widely spread one is joyeux anniversaire. And that's also interesting because we do have this word in Spanish and Catalan, aniversari, aniversario. Yeah, and Catalan aniversari also means the day of your birthday. But in Spanish, for instance, it's used for other situations. So for instance, yeah, aniversario de bodas or something like that. So, but not for the day of your birthday. Yeah. Yeah, what I also find interesting is Italian, where I think the most widely spread one is tanti auguri. So for me, it translates to something like so many wishes. We do not see the word years here. We do not see the word birthday also. So it's interesting. It's a different way to say that. And yeah, in German, we have different ways to say that, but the most widely spread is alles Gute, but you can also say alles Gute zum Geburtstag. So you can say both. So you're wishing the best for the birthday of the person, and so you say alles Gute. You can also say alles Gute und Liebe zum Geburtstag. It's like the longer sentence, so everything good and love to your birthday. Yes, it's also interesting. And from the languages I speak, I'm only missing Russian, where you just say s dnём rashtenia, s dnём rashtenia, so to the day of your birth, basically. So yeah, I think it would be very interesting to see how this is said in other languages. For instance, I know in Basque, you say Zorionak, Zorionak, I think it's pronounced, maybe someone can confirm, because I have some Basque friends, and sometimes when it's my birthday, then they just write Zorionak, and I know it's, I think it's also not only for birthday, but also for other occasions you can use that, but yeah, I've only been told that for my birthday. Yeah, and yeah, I think it would be very interesting to see how it's said in other languages. For instance, I was googling this and I found that in Swedish you say something like gratis, which is funny for me because it's like free in Spanish, Catalan, gratis. So I don't know how to pronounce that. So I think it would be very interesting if you guys just leave a comment and say, how do you say this in your language and how would you translate it literally into English? I know it's not really how it sounds in your language, but I think it's just funny to compare it because it's just so different, a different way to give some good wishes for someone's birthday. So I think it's really, really interesting. I hope you liked the video, and yeah, I hope to see you soon in the channel. If you liked it, just leave a thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to the channel, and just write down maybe what would you like to see in the channel, if you like this kind of multilingual videos or videos where I'm comparing the different languages I speak, or you're like, no, please focus on, I know I get some messages of people like, hey, focus on Russian, and then some others like, hey, you should do more Catalan videos. So to be honest, I'm trying to do a little of everything because for me it's also more fun and I think it's then more useful for everyone. But of course, if you, for instance, are learning Spanish, you'll be like, I have to wait for the videos to come. So yeah, that's the way it is for now. I might change the direction if I notice that the majority of people are like looking for something specific. But for now, I really like having different stuff, like different languages, different focuses, because it's also for me like more fun. But yeah, feel free to leave a comment and to say what you would prefer in the future, and I'll see what I can do. Okay guys, so see you in the next video. Bye!